Greetings, fellow Oaklands. Welcome back to some more Elder Scrolls Arena. We are right now. I think we are in the Summerset Isles, some place in the Summerset Isles. I don't know. The last time we left off, we basically finished looking for, you know, locating basically the crystal-like Law Tower. And today's order of business is to basically, well, go ahead and raid that place for the next piece of the Staff of Chaos. I think this should wrap up a total of 5 pieces, and yeah, I mean, we are getting closer to the end of the game. This is an area of courtesans, a courtyard of courtesans, right around, right around a brothel, an inn, right near the city gates at that. But yeah, so basically, without further ado, let's go ahead and get it done. So, oh yeah, so something I forgot to tell you. The loot from the last place, it didn't appear to be much, but it gave me, like, so much money. It literally doubled my coin selling all that loot. Alright, so here's the crystal-like Law Tower, the Crystal Tower in this case. Based on the current weather, it'll take 6 days to travel here. The total distance is 340 kilometers. Works for me. Excuse me. Ah, yes, screenshot time. Alright, so the Crystal Tower. That actually looks pretty nice. I mean, the ravines here, and you've got an entire gorgeous tower here. I mean, I guess that's why they call it the Crystal Tower, because it just looks so shiny for something that's made of stone. Crystal Tower. The Crystal Tower dominates the area, rising like an accusatory finger pointing at the sky above. That's one way to put things. This bastion of sorcery seemingly transcends normal human conceptions, existing in many places other than this. Planes other than this. Ah, yes. I remember now. It's one of the towers which actually exists in multiple realms, including, like, one of the instances of this tower is here in the other. You can find the others in across various planes in Oblivion as well, so yeah. You can sense the fifth piece of the Staff of Chaos somewhere above. Time to arm ourselves, and yeah, no weapons. No ambush, no entry ambush this time, so I'm just gonna save the game here. You enter the halls of the Crystal Tower, breathed by strange sounds, I guess. I mean, the sounds definitely are strange, and this is the strangest ever way I've seen, I mean, pathway. But then again, I mean, I think this is a tower which we are ascending instead of descending. The troll is regenerating. Seriously? I enter the tower and the first thing I must face is a troll. Well, let's check the map real quick. This area seems a little more spacious than the other places we've been to thus far. I heard a troll screaming, and what I face is skeletons. Are skeletons, but yeah. That was a little disheartening, I suppose. I was expecting to face a troll, not skeletons. I mean, the sound of the troll seems to be coming from over yonder, but, two trolls. This would be interesting. I've never faced two trolls at once. And unfortunately, although I've killed both of them, I cannot loot any of them, simply because, well, they're lying on top of each other. Yep, that's what I was waiting for. Nothing usable. Should I wait for them? I don't know. What's the point? Wait, what was that? That was a door of some sort. I guess we'll go here then. Oh yeah, right here. This door. Did we come through here? No, I don't think so. Alright, so yep. More corridors here. Man, this area is full of trolls, isn't it? Just a staff for my efforts, that's it. One thing that I did notice was as in when I... What the hell was that? As I keep progressing throughout the game, I seem to need more and more potions of healing. And I guess that sort of makes sense. I mean, the game is supposed to rise in the level of difficulty as you, you know, progress through it. So this lock looks difficult, and I think I'm back in the same area that I was before. Yes, I am. So this entire area seems a little... Hey, would you look at that? The objective is right here. Do we really want to explore all this place? I mean, seems a bit like overkill if you ask me. I mean, let's see later. I mean, once we get the Staff of Chaos, once we get the piece of the Staff of Chaos, then we'll decide. So we're gonna take an exit here, we're gonna go down through here, and alright, fine. Ah, a hellhound. Pleased to meet you. Unfortunately, I have to go now. I don't know why I was stuck in that wall over there. Excuse me. Wait, what? Ah, yeah. Sorry. it's over here. The way up looks so much like the way down. Nope, that is the way out. Did I, by any chance, enter the wrong area? Is the way... Huh. So I guess that's how these things work. Huh, I see. So basically the way deeper is marked with blue, the way higher is marked with green. So that's why the first dungeon had like a green spot as the, you know, the exit. So I guess this is the exit then. So yeah, this door, this door, this door. At least I hope. Right? Where did it come from again? Up here. I think it'll be through this area, so let's just go ahead and check that. The footsteps in this part of the map seem a little strange. I mean, that's honestly a chilling thing to hear, you know, that scream that these trolls do. Crystal and a war axe. Now, is the war axe, you know the drill. I mean, if it's enchanted, we keep it. If it's not, then yeah, we drop it. They don't really fetch us a lot of money, so yeah. I mean, I don't know if you guys can hear the footsteps or not, but if you can, then yeah. They're not exactly the normal sort of footsteps. Yep, that seems to be at least one of the ways to proceed to the next level there. Bracelet and steel helm. Is it enchanted though? Nope, it is not. Yeah, so this is basically the way to go higher up. And that's why it was colored that way. Oh, these things. Fighting them is always such a pain in the ass because they just take away so much of your health. What was that? What the hell? Whatever that is, it does not sound good. What is that? Is that like a giant or something? Is that something that we have to face? So I guess it was just one large loop? Or not. It wasn't, actually. Let's clear this area out first. Let's see what fate holds for us over here. I mean, I can hear a lot of sounds, but I can't see any enemies. Oh, wait. So... this way actually takes us to a completely different part of the map. You know what? I think we can enter this area through this side, so... let's check that. Let's test that theory out, unless we want to go in here. I mean, I see some gold. Why not? And a bracelet. I mean, the least I can do is take the gold on the way back, right? Right. And now is the plate pauldron enchanted? Somebody chucked a fireball or something at me. I heard that. The question is from which side? Two of these things? Dude, just one of them was enough. Come on. I guess they were just waiting to ambush me then. Wait, what? Yeah, I guess somebody exited one of these rooms here. Oh, and would you look at that? We've already found the way to our next destination, the next stop. And I guess I'm gonna address that eventually. But first I wanna clear this area out then. If the videos get too long, I'll just trim this part out, because it seems like an unnecessary place to go. I'll just save you, because that sound is sort of giving me the creeps here. Oh my god, seriously. Man, that was hectic. Save time. I don't care what you say, man. If you fight those things, I mean, in that number, if you ever have to fight that many of those things, yeah, you should save. You should count your blessings while you still can, and you should save. Because if you don't, things are probably gonna get really ugly for you in a hurry. Let's check this side out, I guess. It seems to be leading somewhere. Okay, who took a swipe at me? Ah, it was you. How does it feel to be stuck there? At a place where you can't attack me, but where I can attack you. This looks like something. Huh, so I didn't have to take a swim after all. Although, it would have probably been a better idea to take a swim. Or not. I do have to take a swim. Let's take a swim then! Really? Ah yeah, I forgot. The area inwards is on this side. Mace and a silver longsword. I mean, I could probably sell the silver longsword for at least 100 bucks. Let me hold on to it for now, and if I get something that's worth more than that, then I'll just drop it. What the hell is that? Now, what do I want to use? Let's see here. What marks do we have? Visits fire? I think we can use that right now. Huh. So is this what battling with a mage is like? You know, battling as a mage character? Just pressing you all the time, healing yourself, and trying desperately to check fireballs at things which you cannot fathom. These things, up close, they aren't, like most range classes in this game, they aren't too much to handle, but from a distance, well, it's best if you save. Often. But I guess a huge part of that is because I don't have a lot of willpower in this game, even in real life. So this was sort of a pointless area to come down. But hey, at least I could finish those columns, if that counts for anything. And we've got a series of rooms here, which I would like to check. Has nothing to fear from me. Let us try pilfering it. Failure. Bash it open. Come on. Open already. I mean, I'm not all that surprised that there are so many magical beings here which you can only damage using... rarer metals. Nothing here. Better use another potion. Can I pilfer it? Nope. Does this ice column have anything usable? No. And finally some loot. Bracelet, battle axe, and a plate helm. And my inventory is already full. Is the battle axe enchanted? No. And yeah. I haven't even checked the plate helm yet. I think I might as well check it, right? Because we've got a free inventory slot right now. Oh, it is enchanted. Good thing I did check it. And in that honor, I shall save you. Oh, thank you for opening the door for me. How gentlemanly of you. I can't pick up the bracelet. I wonder if I should pick it up though. I mean, I could probably drop the silver longsword because it really won't fetch me a lot. I mean, the best it can fetch me is like $100 or so. But a bracelet, on the other hand, this stuff basically starts from 230 or something. So I think it makes sense that I pick that up instead of the longsword. These golems are something else though. I mean, as a melee class, I don't know if you say the word that way, melee, but yeah, as a melee class, I like to call it melee. So as a melee class, correct me if I'm wrong though, as a melee class, you really need like rarer metals, at least elven, in order to deal with these ghouls. Like, not ghouls, these golems. Golems? Yeah, golems, not golems. My precious. So, yeah, I mean, without melee weapons, without ranged weapons, sorry. What am I saying? Come on. What is this guy doing? Is he floating on the air? He seems to be, but I don't think I need to engage him. I mean, he's stuck. He's glitching out there. Ooh, 102 gold. Yeah, my inventory's full. That's a sad thing to hear. But I shall take it nonetheless. Can I open the door from here? No? Do I need to drop down? Really? Let me save it in temp. Really? Well, that was something. Huh. I guess this is where you would want potions of levitation and stuff like that. Do you have a potion of levitation for me? No, you do not.
3 hours later.
Yes, I do. Good. So remind me not to enter that place again. Was there anything else here? No, not really. It's fine, we don't need to visit all of these areas. So I guess back out we go, and over to this side then. There seems to be another way, like an entire section of the map over here, over on this side, but yeah, I guess I'll refrain from exploring that. Doesn't really seem to be of use at this point. I'm going the right way, right? Yeah, I am. I have to tell you though, those stomps, they sound crazy. Is there anything here? Nope. I mean, there is something over on that side, but yeah, not right here. Really? Snow wolves. The curious thing about wolves in these games, in this game is that they always have their left paw up. Now, wolves and dogs in general, they only do that when they're basically concentrating on something. So I guess they're really concentrating on freezing me over in this instance. Or so I would suppose. I think, if anything, this path should take me to the objective. So let me just go ahead and travel this way. Let me just save the game in temp, just in case. It has nothing to fear from me. Can I not build for it? Fail. Let me just quickly check on the durability of this sword, because by the end of the last episode, it's worn. It wears out quickly. Elvish steel. Yeah, this is used. I've only got the broadsword of speed and I also have a silver longsword, but I don't know how much that'll work. Oh shit, I'm in a bad spot, aren't I? I am in a very bad spot. The Dwarven Mace of Shock Resistance. Oh boy. I think I should stop bashing with this sword then. I mean, I think this should be the way anyway. I don't know why, but these swords are getting worn out super quick. And I'm not sure how I like that. This looks like a shortcut, nifty little shortcut to over all the way onto this side, so I guess that's good. Let me just heal myself and save quickly. I mean, I did just save right now, but oh well. Wait, what attacked me? That's what I was hearing all this time. And a ghoul! Where's the ghoul? Nope, these are wraiths, not ghouls. I wish you care to die, please? Thank you! And some loot. Now... I mean, do I... Yeah... I do want this. It seems to be a plate... it seems to be a helm of agility. The problem is, all of my swords, and I was thinking about doing that before starting off this episode, but I didn't for some reason. I thought that I could like make it work without it, but with these new waves of enemies, all of my weapons seem to be getting worn out really, really fast. And yeah, I mean, it's something. An amulet. I think I'll just drop the silver longsword. Do I want to though? I mean, the amulet, I could appreciate what the amulet is giving me. The silver longsword, if I don't have a weapon, it will basically be my weapon. So, and that is one eventuality which seems more and more possible with the way I'm playing this game. So, I mean, at least with the state of my weapons. So, I'll just save this here and proceed on to the next level.